My name's Ashley Tarantula. I am a RN on the pediatric acute care floor at Penn State Health Children's Hospital. I've been working here for about 3 years, and in 2019, I completed my nurse residency here, and with two of my colleagues we completed our evidence-based practice project together. Unfortunately, my two colleagues have since left the institution and moved out of state, so I will be presenting our project on behalf of the three of us. And our project is treating with technology, virtual reality for pediatric pain. So when we kind of started to decide what we wanted to do for our EBP project, we wanted to do something that the people on our unit would really care about and that could make a difference. So in talking to some of the more senior nurses on our floor, we kind of came to an agreement. We traumatize kids on our floor a lot, which sounds super awful, but it unfortunately is true. We do so many things to our patients that cause them such fear, pain, or anxiety, and it can cause them to have fear of healthcare that will last into adulthood. And currently we have a what we call the Lion's Pledge. So when we are doing procedures that cause pain or anxiety, we use the Lion's Pledge, which is using LMX or numbing cream, using distraction with child life, and comfort positioning. And while that does work, we wanted to kind of find a way that we could figure something out that would work better. So we kind of went in that direction and started our research. And when we started our research, we were finding studies that continued to find that pain remains drastically undertreated in the pediatric population. And not only does that traumatize children, but it can lead to negative outcomes, such as attempts to leave the hospital early, slow recovery, physical signs of stress, changes in eating and sleeping habits, and avoidance of healthcare that can last into adulthood. So we kind of wanted to figure out an innovative way to tackle pain, anxiety in pediatric populations. And I was actually on Facebook and saw this video of this little boy who is getting a vaccine. And when we give children vaccines, like, we have to hold them down so they don't move around. And this little boy was just sitting in a chair, and they put the VR goggles on him, and he sat completely still the whole time, and he watched this little video game, and they kind of paired every sensation he felt getting the vaccine, such as like cold and wet for the alcohol swab. And he was a superhero fighting a big germ. And so when the cold and wet part came, he like sprayed down the germ with icy freezy spray. And then when they injected the vaccine, he sprayed the germ with lava. And it was kind of, instead of feeling the pain and burning of the vaccine, his brain felt the burning or the warmth of the lava that he was spraying instead. And he sat completely still. And when he took the goggles off, he had no idea that he even got a vaccine. And so we just thought that was so incredible, and kind of steered our research then into looking into the use of virtual reality goggles, which led us to our PICO question. Among pediatric medical surgical patients receiving medical intervention, does distraction-based virtual reality therapy decrease perception of pain and discomfort compared to current standards of care? And our current standard of care is the Lion's Pledge. So we went into our literature search. We utilized PubMed and CINAHL, which yielded 8 articles within 7 years that answered our PICO question. And we used the keywords virtual reality, pain or procedural pain, and pediatrics. And the evidence that we evaluated was 4 systemic reviews, a randomized control trial, 1 expert opinion, and a prospective randomized study, and then 1 quasi-experimental study, which all demonstrated VR to be an effective tool to modulate pain during medical procedures. The implementation of VR can decrease pain, anxiety levels, decrease the need for pain meds, and improve results on family satisfaction surveys. So we kind of gathered all this research and found that, yes, VR goggles are great, they're effective, And we could have stopped there, but we wanted to keep going with the project and actually try to implement VR goggles onto our unit. So we had the research done, and then we started talking to our leadership team and told them that we kind of wanted to keep going with our project. We spoke to our child life specialist on our unit to kind of get an idea for how she felt about how this could be implemented, because it would definitely need like a big partnership with child life. And then additionally kind of figure out why we haven't used these in the past, because in our research, we also found most children's hospitals actually do, because it's kind of, so it's kind of a way we've almost fallen behind as an institution. And in these discussions, our clinical staff leader actually approached us and told us about a grant one of the pediatric surgical attendings has. And this is a physician that's committed to innovative projects, and he has a grant to support innovation in the hospital. So we applied for the grant towards the end of 2019, and we got approved for the grant. And so we actually were able to purchase the VR goggles and an iPad, and then also have some money left over as well in order to purchase the programming and games and that sort of thing needed to use the virtual reality goggles. So then our next steps, we kind of started, we would have to talk to cybersecurity, infection control, work on educating the staff on our floor, how to use the goggles, how to properly store, clean them in between use, all of that. And then eventually get IRB approval and continue evaluating the effectiveness of the goggles in the future. So we were in the process of speaking with cybersecurity about everything, which was about this time last year. And then COVID happened, which kind of had to put all of this on the back burner, which we totally understood. So it's kind of been on pause for the past year, but with the help of my manager, I just started the discussion with cybersecurity again, now that COVID is kind of under control a little better. So I'm really excited to see where the project goes and see kind of where we're at a year from now and just implement these on our unit and be able to see firsthand. We've seen in the research that this works great, but I'm excited to see firsthand on our unit how good the VR goggles are to decrease pain and anxiety in our patients. So thank you so much for listening to our presentation. If you have any comments, questions, any advice for us, we would love to hear from you. You can feel free to email me. My email is at the bottom, but it's atranchell, T-R-A-N-C-H-E-L-L, at pennstatehealth.psu.edu. Thank you so much.